The concepts of algebra, trigonometry, and calculus originated in ancient India. Quadratic equations were used by Sridharacharya in the 11th century. The largest numbers, the Greeks and the Romans, used were 106, whereas Hindus used numbers as big as 10 to the power of 53, with specific names, as early as 5000 BC during the Vedic period. Bandra Worli ceiling has steel wires equal to the Earth's circumference. It took a total of 2 crores 57 lakhs man hours for completion and also weighs as many as 50,000 African elephants. It is a bridge that links Bandra in the western suburbs of Mumbai with Worli in South Mumbai. It is a cable stayed bridge with pre-stressed concrete steel viaducts on either side. 1,000-year-old Shiva Temple in Tamil Nadu is the world's first all-granite temple. The Brihadeeswarar Temple at Tanjavur in Tamil Nadu is the world's first complete granite temple, which is reportedly built using about 130,000 tons of granite. The 1,000-year-old temple, dedicated to Lord Shiva, houses 216 feet tall, 80-ton heavy Vimana tower. According to Indian Saras Act, 1867, any individual can ask for water free of charge from any hotel at any time for themselves and their pets. Furthermore, he or she can use the washroom for free, and no one can stop them. Even any five-star hotel can't prohibit you from drinking potable water and using its washrooms. Shampooing is an Indian concept. Shampoo was invented in India, not the commercial liquid ones, but the method by use of herbs. The word shampoo has been derived from the Sanskrit word champu, which means to massage. The first known mention of shampoo is from the 4th century BC, when Greek historian Strabo wrote about India's practice of shampooing. The game of snakes and ladders was created by the 13th century poet Saint Gyandev. It was originally called Mokshapat. The historic version had its roots in morality lessons, on which a player's progression up the board represented a life journey complicated by virtues, ladders, and vices, snakes, which means good deeds take people to heaven, and evil, to a cycle of rebirths. As per the Indian Treasure Trove Act, if one discovers anything of value exceeding 10 rupees hidden under the soil, then one must report it. If one fails to report, he/she is liable to punishment. The law is opposed by professional treasure hunters because the law says that all the findings of treasure hunters belong to the government.